the vastness of space and the dynamics of celestial bodies present a fascination that has haunted people for millennia. The dominant force in this structure is commonplace and mysterious for us at the same time, gravity. The effort to understand gravity has kept many of the great minds of humanity occupied. From Galileo to Newton to Einstein, these great minds have furthered our knowledge of gravity, and many applications of gravitational theories have been put to use. In this connection, the measurement of the local acceleration of gravity is the basis, whether to use it or to take a look at the structure of the Earth masses in geodesy. Since the time of Galileo's freefall experiments, measurement methods have evolved significantly, but the principle of gravity measurement is still the same, even with today's modern gravimeters. A test mass is dropped and the time until it reaches the bottom is recorded. From this, the acceleration due to gravity can be calculated. In essence, the longer the mass takes to fall, the smaller the magnitude of the gravitational acceleration. However, this measurement method has some inherent disadvantages.
This mass has to be moved. It is transported by an elevator to the top. The elevator is greatly accelerated with nearly 2g, then it slows down again. The mass hovering in the elevator, and then the elevator is readjusted and below the test mass is caught again. And this whole mechanism is a very strong mechanical movement, which also generates vibrations. The gravimeter disturbs itself.
Other influences, such as small mechanical changes to the equipment or the test mass, may interfere with conventional gravimeters. Thus, measurements are very sensitive to fluctuations and therefore have to be repeated often. Another key issue is that the measuring instruments are very large and hardly transportable. Accurate measurements are therefore an extremely complex and highly expensive procedure. A promising development towards compactification and improvement of gravimetry arises from the field of atom physics. With a technique of matter-wave interferometry, conventional test masses are replaced by a collection of atoms in high vacuum. By using lasers, these atoms can be manipulated quantum mechanically to yield gravimetric measurements.
In our atom gravimeters, we actually look at test masses which are free-falling, but the test masses are actually atoms, and we use quantum technologies to monitor their displacement.
In contrast to conventional test masses, individual atoms do not wear out. There are no disturbing vibrations. Due to the vacuum, they are uncoupled from environmental factors that interfere with current gravimeters. Atom optic gravity acceleration measurements are based on matter wave interferometry. Its precision became possible with the emerging technique of laser cooling, from which the discoverer was awarded the Nobel Prize in 1997.
It's something that started about, I would say, 20 years ago, or a bit more now. And it's the physical advances that has allowed people to stop the motion of atoms in a gas. So in a room, for instance, molecules of air moves at a very large speed, 300 meters per second, like a plane. And people have learned how to use lasers to stop atoms so that they can look at them for longer. And so that's the key idea, is that once atoms stop moving, you can use them to do something. And that's because atoms are sensitive to a lot of things. They're sensitive to magnetic field, they're sensitive to light, they're sensitive to gravity, and this is what we're going to use. So you can use them as probes.
In the iSense project, funded by the European Union since 2010, several European universities collaborate to achieve the goal of a practical of a quantum gravimeter. Since the beginning of the new millennium, scientists have developed quantum sensors in laboratory setups, employing matter-wave interferometry to measure gravity. These matter-wave interferometers are on the same competitive level of sensitivity with current classical absolute gravimeters. Currently, however, their size and mechanical sensitivity is still a constraint for practical applications.
It's still a laser table full of optics, like mirror mounts, lasers, everything very fragile, not temperature stable. And you can't imagine putting that into the field without breaking immediately or misaligning.
But to realize a fully portable quantum gravimeter for field applications, significant technological developments have been necessary. The perfect combination of optics lasers, electronics, microcomputers, magnetic fields and vacuum technology in a measuring apparatus presents a vast challenge for scientists. Thus, a joint allocation of resources and expertise from across Europe is needed.
The iSense project is very ambitious. It involves many different technologies and particularly the aspect of portability really pushes the boundaries of how small and how robust each component in the system is.
A major component of the lab setup are the optical components for configuring and controlling the light. First, the laser itself needs to be reduced in size to take up minimum space. Then, the complex optical systems used to adjust the laser beam have to be made both smaller and robust in the face of disturbances. The solution here, integrated optical waveguide chips that, while occupying the smallest amount of space, perform the same tasks as a whole table of mirrors, screens, lenses, and light conducting fibers.
A big step forward technologically is to replace the bulk fiber optic components with waveguides that are fabricated on a semiconductor chip that will carry light and perform optical functions at 780 nanometer wavelength.
In the progress of their research, the participants of iSense entered completely new territory and developed components that had never been realized before. Both the fields of technology development and fundamental research obtained remarkable results. An achievement that would have been impossible without the rich infrastructure created in the research collaboration.
We have brought together experts from across Europe, so it can't be done by a single group alone. We need experts in laser manufacture to do the diode lasers and micro-integrate them with optics into a tiny device which is very robust and intrinsically stable. We need experts in nanofabrication to do the integrated optical waveguides and distribution modules. We need experts in atom interferometry schemes to look into schemes which are don't take as much space as a free-fall scheme. And we need experts in integration of the whole thing so that we can really make the instrument into a small enough box and make it independent to move out into the field.
Size does matter. It requires less stuff to carry the gravimeter, and reaching remote areas becomes easier. Even satellite missions are attractive to do large-scale measurements over the entire globe.
The accuracy of atomic interferometers increases with the measurement time. So you try to let the atoms fall as long as possible, and it works excellent on satellites under the extended freefall. And therefore, we try to perform such experiments on satellites.
Here, the scientists have to face another challenge, since both energy and space are limited resources on board of satellites.
Perhaps the most important advantage of integrated miniaturized components in the type of experiment we're describing in iSense is that the power consumption of such a device is much lower than a macroscopic device would ever be.
But this research does not stop at miniaturization. The Leibniz University of Hanover, amongst others, is already investigating the application of matter wave interferometry in microgravity and space environments. Here, experimental tests of Einstein's theory of relativity provides the main motivation for scientists. The scientists did already demonstrate the high-precision production and manipulation of ultra-cold atoms up to states which are beyond the classical understanding of particles and therefore can only be described by quantum mechanics. After the successful research on matter wave interferometers in microgravity on Earth, the next step is to place these sensors onto rockets, which soon will carry the first quantum sensor into space. One particular innovation in the manipulation of cold atoms is constituted by atom chips. These microcircuits carry very fine conductor structures, generating magnetic fields in a very confined space, which can be employed to manipulate cold atoms very precisely.
We think that atom chips are a very interesting technology for satellites. They allow for realization of experiments which have previously used the whole lab on the smallest space. With the help of these extremely compact structures, we're also able to reduce the energy consumption significantly, so that one can think about performing such measurements on satellites. That will be of great interest both for gravimetry in space, as well as for fundamental physics experiments, and maybe in the future for the detection of gravitational waves with atoms.
Although it will still take a while before the application of quantum sensors will be commonplace for everyday use, the iSense consortium benefits from the sharing of knowledge, as well as the international comparison.
Certainly, we are in a leading role worldwide in terms of both the quantum sensor systems and the technology aspects, meaning, to what extent are we able to bring complex experiments from the laboratory to the field?
Results from this work have major applications outside of the field of fundamental physics. Geophysicists and geodesists already have high hopes for the application of quantum gravimetry.
Because we are much faster with the new devices, perhaps even more accurately, we can much better monitor processes which are regional and on a small scale to groundwater based. We get much better models for the variation of groundwater, and that are again important input data for other applications.
There are vast opportunities, yet also enormous challenges. But thanks to the iSense project, the doors have been opened for a promising future in the age of quantum sensors.